this table. You sure?
Yeah. We'll bend the board.
Service. We've been praying for this service for a long time.
thankful before God for His blessings and His goodness that He showered upon us, and especially upon both families, Pastor Matthew K. Matthew and Dr. Achugun. Their wonderful families, they could experience the goodness of God in their life for the last several years. I know that this is a precious moment in the life of Joshua and Rachel. You can smile. My name is Maurice George. I've been ministering the Lord back in Philly. I just want to take this opportunity to introduce today's stars, Joshua and Rachel, and their wonderful family. I've been ministering the Lord back in New York 5 years ago, around 6 years we've been there. And Pastor Matthew K. Matthew and Sister Susan, they were the active members of our church. And we have a lot of things to share about this wonderful family. We dearly call Matthew K. Matthew as Monachai, a kind-hearted, compassionate, great man of God, sincerely following Jesus Christ and a disciple of Jesus Christ. And this afternoon I have a lot of things to mention in this special moment, but because of the brevity of time, I'm not going to explain everything. Monachai and Susan, they've been serving the Lord for the last several years. They have a wonderful spiritual legacy. As all some of you know that Susan is the daughter of great man of God, Pastor Matthew Samuel, one of the pioneers of the Pentecostal movement back in Kerala, and a well-known preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Now he rests in peace, and he is with our Lord. Sister Susan and Monachai, as I mentioned earlier, a wonderful family. We had a lot of good memories in our life because of their hospitality. I don't know how many of you know that Susan is one of the best known cook in the New York area. Joshua, you are so lucky. And Monachai and Susan, their children, Daryl, Jeffrey, and Rachel. Rachel is one of the best known singers, of gospel singers of our town. And we had the privilege for our son's marriage. She was the one who sang for the glory of God while we were in Dallas. Rachel is a music teacher, right? She teaches voice and piano in a non-profit organization. And we had a very wonderful time for the last several years. She loves us, and we love Rachel so much, and we've been praying for her. Rachel, this is your moment. God bless you. We know that you are a wonderful young girl serving the Lord, singing for the glory of God. May God bless you. We all know that Dr. Achugun and the Sister Sarah Kaur. Sister Sarah Kaur is the daughter of great woman of God, Mary Kaur, back in Kerala. She was serving the Lord for the last several years, preaching the gospel, one of the mainline women preachers of the gospel back in Kerala and all around the world. These both families have inherited spiritual legacy, and they've been serving the Lord and their children. They've been standing for the glory of God. Susan's mom, Chalamama, is here. Thank you, Lord, bless us together this evening, especially this afternoon. Bible says this is the day that the Lord has made. We are here to rejoice in the presence of God, while God is going to join Joshua and Rachel as one family. Today onwards, you are going to stand as a family, for the glory of God and for the expansion of the kingdom of God. We know that you will preach the gospel, you will sing for the glory of God, and God will use you for the expansion of his kingdom. Great man of God, Pastor Cecil Matthew, he is going to solemnize this wedding. I know him. He's a great man of God serving the Lord. Pastor Cecil, thank you very much. God bless you. And Pastor Subi is going to share the message today. And Pastor Rajan is going to bless this couple after a few minutes. We just want to welcome each and every one of you. I know that many pastors are here. So many pastors are here. Friends, families, groomsmen, bridal party, all of you, we just want to welcome you. Let's sit in the presence of God in a prayerful attitude. God is going to bless each and every one of us with his presence and with his power. The word of God is going to share in our midst this afternoon. That will be a blessing for us, for our families, and for the glory of God. I just want you to be in the presence of God with a prayerful attitude. We know that God is here. We are here to exalt the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Monitayan and Susan, once again, we as a family, me and my wife Jolie, our children Abby and Gina, Freddie, Gabby, and little Oliver, we extend our sincere thanks to all of you, and congratulations, Joshua, Rachel, God bless you.
Fulfilled in a moment. Your name is the highest. Your name is the greatest. Your name stands above them all.
once again. So what is covenant? The Hebrew word for the word covenant is the word berith, which means passing through. And the Lord says through the prophet Malachi that I was a witness on the day that you cut covenant with the wife of your youth. And we are all here today as witnesses. And I want to thank God for the people that have traveled from the different states. But the greatest witness that we have today as this covenant is being made is God Himself. He is present today to witness this covenant and is very happy. And the angels are around here because God never travels alone. Where He is, angels are there. Witness this covenant. So it says that I witnessed the covenant between you and the wife of your youth.
Why is he speaking about the wife of Jehu? Let me tell you, Joshua. You're going to live the longest years with Rachel. I don't know how old you are now, but the years that you have lived are fewer to the years that you're going to live with Rachel. And God honors the covenant that you're making today. But then, what is the power of covenant? I'm going to share a few things here, and then I'm going to pray for the minutes that I have. Point number one, covenants are made between the stronger and the weaker. You never make covenant with somebody that has what you have. So, today, two people that are different are making covenant. Rachel has a uterus, and Joshua has the seed. Because when you make covenant, you enjoy from somebody what they have that you don't have. And that is why covenant can only be between a husband and a wife, and not the other way. So, we are in a covenant relationship with God. God is a God of covenant, and he made covenant with us because we are weak and God is so powerful. Amen. So he made covenant with us, and when he made covenant with us, because when you make covenant with a person, what happens is that what belongs to that person now belongs to you. Amen. And what belongs to you belongs to that person. Just like from today, Rachel, this body is not yours. It belongs to Joshua, and Joshua's body also belongs to you. So, through the power of covenant, we are able to access everything that God has, because we are no longer two, but now we are one with the Lord. And if you came here and you're not born again, I want to encourage you today to accept Christ as your personal Savior, so that you can enter into the covenant relationship with God. So, covenants are cut for the benefit. God's covenant is basically for our benefit, because our being with God does not add anything to him, and our absence from him does not subtract anything from him. Secondly, covenants becomes strong when we fight for each other's battles. In the book of Genesis chapter 14 and verse 16, the Bible says, "And he divided himself against them, he and his servants, by night, and smote them, and pursued them unto Hobah, which is one on the left hand of Damascus. And he brought back all the goods, and also brought again his brother Lot and his goods, and the women also, and the people." You see, when you enter into covenant with somebody, it means that that person must be there for you in good and bad times. God called Abraham in Genesis chapter 12, but God never made a covenant with Abraham until Genesis chapter 15. And what was the reason that made God to cut a covenant with him was because in Genesis chapter 14, Abraham went and fought a battle that he was not supposed to fight, because Lot had been taken as a captive in Babylon, in the province of Sinai. And you know very well how Abraham had separated with Lot. That was not a battle that he was supposed to fight. But he went and fought that battle and brought back Lot because of God's purposes. Because Ruth, who was a Moabite, was later on to come through the family of Lot, and she later on became the great-grandmother of Jesus Christ. So, in Genesis chapter 15, because Abraham was willing to fight God's battles, because the battle of Lot was not Abraham's battle, but it was a battle of God, God now decides to make covenant with Abraham for the first time in Genesis chapter 15. So even in marriage, when we get married, we have to, because it is a covenant, we have to be concerned about each other's challenges and be willing to lay down our lives for the sake of the others. Jesus Christ said in the book of John that what greater love is there than for a man to lay down his life for the sake of his brethren. So those of us who are married, for us to strengthen our covenant relationship with our spouses, we must be willing to fight their battles, to fight their challenges. And if we're going to strengthen our covenant relationship with God, then we must also be willing to fight God's battles, not just our battles. I see people who just like to pray for themselves and bless themselves and pray for their dogs and pray for their cats, but they never try to inquire from God, what issues do you want me to be praying for? So our covenants can be weak or they can be strong. Where there is a covenant, there will always be intimacy. You know? Because covenant makes us to be one. And so, when there is intimacy, there is always access. Let me tell you, Joshua, in Kenya, women speak 40,000 words per day. I don't know about the American sisters. So, one thing is that, and I'm talking about Kenyan ladies, please don't beat me, I'm not talking about American ladies. 40,000 words every day, and Elsad said that they speak 15,000 words at their place of work and store 25,000 words for their husband. So, you must be willing to listen. And listen, and listen, and listen. You know, many men nowadays don't have time for their wives. That is why the covenant is very weak. I have a friend of mine who told me that I don't have time to speak to my wife and my children. So I created a family WhatsApp. So whatever they want, they just post it there. They say, Daddy, we love you. They post it there. We want to eat fish. They post it there. Because I'm so busy making money. Now, when you have that kind of marriage, the covenant relationship is not strong. Just like the way, if we don't spend time every day speaking to God, our covenant relationship with Him is not strong. It becomes weak. But when the covenant is strong, you're having communion, you are relating every day, then it gives you access. For example, I've been married for the last 20 years. I just celebrated my 20 years of marriage. And, you know, my covenant relationship with my wife is very strong. We pray together. She has access to all my emails, to all my phones. I know there are some men here, your phone, your wife cannot touch it. You keep on changing the codes and changing the codes and changing the codes because you are hiding something. You are looking at me very sternly. Is everything okay? Hallelujah. Yeah, so because covenant is not strong, so you cannot have access. When covenant is strong, your wife will have access to all your money and the husband will also have access to everything. But that covenant to be strong, it must be nurtured. For us to have a strong covenant relationship with God, we have to nurture that relationship. We have to spend time with God. We have to have our mind, our soul, our spirit on the things that God is interested in. He said that seek you first the kingdom of God and all these other things shall be added unto you. When a covenant is strong, there is a lot of trust. One time I went to preach in the nation of Tanzania. And after I preached there, they blessed me with a lot of things. But we left early in the morning, around 5 in the morning. And we came back, so I get to the house, to my house, and my wife is there who unpacks the blessings that I come with. And so my wife unpacks the blessings, and he sees there an old nika, an innerwear of the lady. So I came back from the church and my wife was very upset. She said, you came back with a lot of clothes, but There is a cloth that I found that you must explain where it came from. And she showed me this cloth. It was an innerwear of a lady. And I could not believe that the things that I've been given were there. But what had happened was the pastor who had hosted me had kept the clothes that the ladies had brought in her daughter's bedroom. So because we left and there was no electricity there in the morning, when he went to collect everything, he even collected this other cloth. So my wife was so annoyed. I had to call the pastor and ask the pastor, you know, what happened? Because there is a cloth here that I don't understand where it has come from. And the good thing, help me to go nowadays for videos. We have to put it on video. And the pastor said, actually, my daughter was asking, where did that cloth go? But my wife was able to believe me because we have a strong covenant relationship with God. When there is strong covenant, there is trust. I was just telling Joshua, you know, his aunties were just trying to hug him, and they left some makeup on his clothes, praise the Lord. So I was telling Joshua, wow, you need to clear that, you know. Tell your neighbor the power of covenants. Hallelujah. Thirdly, covenants are unbreakable. You do not stay in marriage because you feel like. I usually say that marriage is a car that has no reverse gear. It only has one gear. That is a forward gear. You don't change your mind because somebody snores. You don't change your mind. I mean, covenants are different from contracts. A covenant is everlasting. When you enter into a covenant, you are not thinking about pulling out of that covenant. It is a mockery to God for God to come and witness such an auspicious ceremony. People have traveled from all over. You know, I have also traveled all the way from Kenya to come and be here. I wouldn't have been here if this family is not so special to me, you know, because of a lot of work that we have in the ministry and in the government. And then you decide to break such a powerful covenant through a lawyer, you know. You break such a powerful covenant through mothers-in-laws and fathers-in-laws, you know. So the covenant, it is the same thing when we accept Christ, we give our life to Jesus as our personal Savior. It is not something to try and get out. God has called us to have an eternal relationship with Him that is going to lead us up to eternity. So if you're here and you're not born again, you've never accepted Christ as your personal Savior, I want to encourage you, child of God, because the second most powerful covenant on planet Earth is the covenant of marriage. And everything about marriage is a reflection of the eternal covenant that we are ushered into when we accept Christ as our personal Savior. So if you're here, you backslid, your relationship has not been doing well with the Lord, I want to encourage you today to make a comeback with God, because this covenant is very, very powerful, and it is supposed to last forever. Finally, let me share on the last part, and then we will get into prayer. Covenants, when we make covenants, covenants make us to be unstoppable. You see, when a husband and a wife come together, I have been a pastor for so many years, and I see couples coming to my office for counseling. You know, I have officiated in many, many, many weddings. Many couples in Africa would come to the aisle to, you know, to get married when they have nothing, absolutely nothing. They are poor, you know. I remember the day when I got married. I'll never forget that day because I was very, very poor. In fact, I remember my sister came to check my house because I'm a Ugandan, but I was getting married in Kenya. So my sister came to spend time in my house on the eve of the wedding. And she asked me, is this the baby you have? I said, yes. And this is the blanket, I said, yes. And where is the bride going to sleep? I said, on that bed. And she said, oh Lord, have mercy over that bride. Because I had a blanket, I had a mattress, but I didn't even have sheets. You know, I never had bed sheets. But anyway, behold, God is a God who is amazing. We go for the wedding, and God stirred up some people. I came back with a lorry of things into my house. And my sister said, now I believe you're a man of God. You know? Anyway, what I'm saying, I keep on officiating over weddings, and people come to get married. They are miserable, they are poor, they have nothing. Then they enter into a covenant relationship. And then they begin to, you know, they become one, they are united, they agree together, they pray together, they share the word of God together, they are serving in church together. And I see those people getting blessed, coming out of poverty, having children, moving from lousy estates to better estates, and then they begin to buy properties, and then they begin to prosper. What am I saying? When people come, a man and a woman come into covenant, there is a supernatural power that is unleashed that can break any opposition. It's the same thing when we come into a strong covenant relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. We know that Joshua, a mere man, was able to stop the sun. Not because Joshua was powerful, but because he was in covenant with the creator of the universe. The sun would listen to him, not on Joshua's account, but because he was in covenant with a very powerful human being. I'm a superhuman, and that is our God. So, when we enter into covenant with God and activate that covenant, what we cannot do in our own lives and in our own abilities, based on that covenant, we will be able to do and we will be able to achieve. So, I want to pray today for people, because covenant is the highest expression of commitment. When you make a covenant, what I say, today Joshua is saying what? I am committed to you for life. And Rachel is saying, I am committed to you for life. Likewise, in the realm of the spirit, why God makes covenant with us is because the spiritual realm never commits itself to anybody that is not in covenant relationship. You know? So, because covenant is commitment. So, if you're here today, you've not accepted Christ, you want to experience that covenant, I am gonna pray for you. And as I have said, covenant has power. Some of you came here, you are sick in your body, your marriage is not doing well, you're having a lot of challenges in your marriage. The Lord is going to restore you. I want you to close your eyes. I am going to pray right now because I was requested to pray and bless everybody that has come for this wedding in Jesus' name. I want to request everybody that is married, please just stand up. Those of you who are married, just stand up, hold your spouse. If he's here, just join your hands together. I'm going to pray for you in Jesus' mighty name. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I bless your children that are here. I release the power of the Holy Ghost. I pray for the healing of marriages. I pray for the restoration of the first love. Many marriages are going through challenges, but I pray today, let there be restoration of the first love. Let there be healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Any marriage that is experiencing tremendous challenges, we speak a new page, we speak a new start, we speak healing, we break the powers of darkness that fight against marriages, and we decree and declare that every marriage under this roof, it shall stand until the days that you appointed for them have been accomplished in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Amen. I want to pray for the sick. Somebody here, you are having issues with your skin. Somebody, you're having back problems. Somebody, you're having kidney issues. Somebody, you're having ulcers. Just raise your hand. I want to pray for you. If you're sick in your body, just raise your hand. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you for raising your hand. You have an affliction. Somebody, you have a migraine headache. The Lord wants to heal you today in the name of Jesus. You have a frozen shoulder. You have ulcers. Just raise your hand. Whatever, don't fear. We are in a celebration. Jesus performed the miracles at the wedding of Cana. He's going to perform a miracle today at this wedding. Don't fear and say, the preacher is out of place. No, I am not out of place. The power of God is here. It is here. Even on barriers, I pray for people to be healed. This is the wedding. You're going to be healed in Jesus' name. Lift your hand. Touch where you have the sickness, and the Lord is going to heal you. Upstairs there, you are sick. Touch where you have somebody who has migraine headache. Just touch. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I break sicknesses. I break afflictions. I break bondages. I release the power of the Holy Spirit over the lives of your people. In Jesus' mighty name, be healed right now. The Bible says on that day, the yoke shall be broken. Let every yoke be broken from your life. Somebody came here, you don't have children. May your womb be opened. May you receive the capacity to bear children. Round about this time next year, have a baby and have a testimony that I was praying for in the Rachel's and Joshua's wedding. And that's where I received my miracle. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Everybody lift up your hands. Let me just request everybody stand up. Everybody stand up and lift up your hands. You want to repeat this prayer after me? Say, Holy Spirit, I desire your power. I desire your fire. Baptize me with your power today. In the name of Jesus, I receive it. I receive your healing. I receive your fire. I receive your grace. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. And if you're not born again, pray this prayer with me. Say, dear Jesus, today I accept you with my heart, and I confess with my mouth that I am born again in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. God bless you.
Amen. Continue to stand as we worship. Turn again in your books. Join us as we affirm this powerful covenant.
Train of his robe.
the ceremony, saturated with the presence and the power of God. I want to invite you to just take your seats in the audience.
Based on the Holy Spirit.
Based on the Holy Scriptures, Joshua, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will, by the grace of God.
Based on the Holy Scriptures, Rachel, will you have this man,
be your husband,
to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep, in sickness and in health, and forsaking
all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
Joshua, this time I ask you to repeat after me. Knowing that this is a lifetime covenant, I trust in my Heavenly Father,
Savior Jesus Christ,
and my helper, the Holy Spirit,
to strengthen me,
to carry out my responsibilities,
so that I can
please.
I, Joshua, take you, Rachel,
to be my wedded wife.
To
have it to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
In sickness and in health.
Love and cherish.
Support, nurture, and respect. According to God's holy ordinance. Until death do us apart. This is my solemn vow of our triune covenant. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Rachel, this time I ask you to repeat it. Knowing that this is a lifetime covenant, I trust in my Heavenly Father, my Savior Jesus Christ, my helper, the Holy Spirit, to strengthen me, to carry out my responsibilities, so that I can please God. I, Rachel, take you, Joshua, to be my wedded husband, to have to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, to support, nurture, and respect, according to God's holy ordinance. Until death do us apart. This is my solemn vow of our triune covenant. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Heaven and His church and earth witness and learn this covenant and commitment you've made to each other. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God.
We declare that you are the fruit
God's blessings, and you will produce fruit that continues to be blessings for the Lord and for his kingdom. So I want to just ask you to just join your right hands together. And church, would you just stretch forth your hands in this moment? Would you just pray right now, wherever you are, just pray.
You go before to prepare a blessing. before the Lord today. As I go to pray, may I ask all the audience, friends and families, would you please stand, let's pray together. As you have seen today, we have taken more time to worship the Lord. We have given more importance to honor God more than anything else. It is God who is the source of all the blessings in our life. We don't consider that we earn or achieve anything by our own strength, but God has given us every potential, every strength that we have at least from Him. So we acknowledge Him and we thank Him for that. For generation to generation, God be our refuge, strength and help. He be the source of all the blessings and grace in our life. I'm so glad that our children have made the choice to make their choice in life in the midst of the saints of God together. We invite the Holy Spirit, we invite the presence of God in their life as they continue their life journey together from this day forward. Therefore, we ask the obstacles and struggles they're going to face, but we know the one who is in them is greater than the one who is in this world. And we believe the word of God says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I shall fear no evil because thou art with me. May the Lord's presence shall be with them, I pray God this time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dear friends, family members, would you please lift your hands towards them now and bless them. We are going to bless them together. Your prayer and support is a great source of strength for them. As you continue to pray for them, the Lord will sustain them and keep them safe under His wings. Hallelujah. Not only today, as often as you remember them, Joshua and Rachel, pray for them. Because they are living in a wicked world where there are so many evil forces surrounding them and trying to entangle them and then to lead them the wrong way. Pray that God will lead them under His wings and focus upon the ways of Jesus. May God shine upon them today. Hallelujah. Our eternal loving Heavenly Father, the Creator of heaven and earth, the one who has the power to hold the seven seas of the earth in the palm of His hand, the God who called the stars of heaven by name, sustain and ever life under the canopy of heaven. The God who is our provider, the protector, the defender of our faith, we praise you and worship you today, Lord. We thank you for Joshua and Rachel for their decision to be joined together in a holy matrimony. We thank God for the parents who are impressed with the life and love to raise them in a godly manner and the fear and the knowledge of the Almighty God. Heavenly Father, we pray that you unite them in your love and commitment to honor you and to live a life that is pleasing unto you. May they live under the shadow of the Almighty God, under the covenant of faith. May they keep the commandments of God all the days of their life and keep a holy covenant they made before God today. We pray that they have blessed and happy life together as you have joined them together. May they seek you first and your righteousness in the life trials and challenges, and rejoice in you in all the life sorrows and in success. The Lord who blessed Adam and Eve, the Lord who blessed Abraham and Sarah, Jacob and Rachel, and all the patriarchs of faith in the past, God who blessed our parents and grandparents, may bless you and prosper you and be fruitful. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord turn His face towards you and give you peace. And now, the love of the Father in heaven, the grace and mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ, fellowship, communion of the Holy Spirit, may abide with you forever. And all God's people say, Amen, Amen, and Amen. Congratulations. God bless you.
I just want to release prophetic words that the Lord put in my heart. The Lord has given you a gift of faith today. As you can hear, the gift of faith has been given to you to do exploits for Him. The Lord is going to give you very beautiful children. And you are possible. You are going to operate in different anointings, different graces, and the Lord is going to bless you. He's blessed your hands, that whatever your hands will touch, they're going to be blessed. Because you're a woman with big hearts, you're a woman that loves to share, and you, both of you, apart from just your children that you want to have, but you also want to be a father and mother to many other children. Spiritual children, but also poor children, they will look at you as fathers and as mothers. So Father, I just prophesy and release this word. And the Lord has also called you for nations. He's going to send you many nations all over the world in the mighty name of Jesus. A great door, a future door has been opened before you. You will not struggle in anything. The Lord has opened the door. Men and women will minister unto me. Father, we thank you and we bless you, Jesus.
for pictures, ushers will dismiss the remaining guests row by row, starting from the back. But if you're family, please remain here. Guests are free to exit based on the usher's instructions. And again, it's Green Tree Country Park. Thank you.
Show it to my kids. Mine's 7, 7, 3, 2, 6, 7, 5.